Hello, aspiring call center agent. This is Naomi C once again. As you can see, we'll talk about the continuation of our topic about 60 call center terminologies or jargons you should know as a call center agent. So this is mainly dedicated for newbies out there. So if you're a newbie, then this is dedicated for you. And if you're a tenured agent already, then that's fine. This is also for you. And so yes, I already covered 1 to 30 of this part, so I'll talk about number 31 to 60 of this part. Alright, so yes, let's talk about service center or store. So this is typically the location or the physical location for a certain company you're working with. For example, in a telecommunications company, for example, AT&T. Of course, in AT&T, they already have an online website and you can already request for refund, replacement, or you can already shop in their online store. But if you wanted to see their physical items or the equipment, replace equipment or return equipment, then the best thing to do is to go visit the service center. So most of the time they're open Mondays to Sundays, but that's limited. That's around like 10 a.m. to 7 p.m. only. And that's it. All right, number 32 is long call. So this is a term that we call when the call that you have with your customer is already over 10 minutes. So if it's 10 minutes and above, that is considered as long call, and you may have high average handling time, so you have to manage your call very well. And then number 33 is callback. So this is a term that we use if our customer disconnected a call for some reason. He got upset and he intentionally disconnected a call. Then we have to call back, like to call the customer back. And or the situation also comes when the call get disconnected unintentionally. Something like, you know, the call just dropped without you and the customer knowing, or maybe as an agent you are working from home and then you suddenly got into trouble with your internet connection. There has been an outage and so the call got disconnected, and so what you have to do is to call the customer back, and that's what we call callback. All right, and then number 34 is follow-up. So this is the term that we use when a customer would request for an agent to call them back in a specific period of time. For example, the customer is busy, she is not able to do the troubleshooting at home because she is currently at work. So she would say, okay, call me when I'm home at 8 o'clock in the evening today. So yes, all you have to do is to set an appointment, create a follow-up in your end, and call the customer back at exactly 8 p.m. All right, so that's it. Number 35 is auto in. So this is what we do when we are already ready to take in calls. Like, for example, your shift starts at 12 midnight, and exactly 12 midnight you have to toggle auto in. That means you are already willing to accept calls and help your customer. 36 is phonetics. So phonetics are the equivalent of the letters A to Z. So we have standard phonetic alphabet. So some agents don't know about phonetics, so they would just say A for apple. They don't know that A stands for alpha, B stands for bravo, C stands for charlie, D for delta, E for echo, and the like. And as an agent, if you want to sound professional with your customer, you want to make sure that you know what is standard phonetic alphabet. All right, and then 37 would be NPS. So in our company, it's what we call Net Promoter Score. So this is mainly about the overall score of your team for a particular fiscal or month. So it is a combination of your surveys about detractors, promoters, and neutral. Alright, that's it. And then 38 is GSR that we call. So this is what we call gross sales revenue. So this is the overall sales of like you. You as an agent, of course, you are a sales agent, for example. And then one of the things that you have to do is to sell either your, for example, your products or internet cable, home phone, home security or mobile services. So each upgrade, side grades that you would do, that would be considered as gross sales revenue, right? So 39 is bio or personal. So this is a specific aux that you use in your computer or in your Avaya, wherein it may seem like this is like personal when you have to kind of pee in the middle of the call, and then you feel like, all right, you're about to pee or something that you have to do. You have to ask for your lead's permission. Okay, TL, can I ask for a personal, like personal toggle? You have to toggle personal, and that means that you're doing personal stuff. You go to conference room and such. And typically the range for this is like 5 to 10 minutes. Okay. And then number 40 is pitch or close sale. So this is mainly for, you know, sales agents. So pitch is when you try to give your customers your, you know, the products, the packages that you have. You try to like engage, like you try to sell a product to a customer. Then close sale is when the customer agreed to, okay, I'll get that, let's do that, and that means you were able to close the sale. All right, so 41 is top agent. So this is the term called for agents who excel in terms of all the metrics. So for example, they are very good in generating promoters, they're very good in generating sales, they're very good in handling customers, and they were able to pass all of the metrics. So yeah, they are called top agent. And number 42 is huddle. So this is the term that most of us don't really like, because this is like an extra time allotted that you're not paid technically. So in the company I'm working with, we have like a huddle of like 30 minutes before shift. So this is kind of like a small meeting with your teams, with your team leader, like discussing what would be the things that you have to do, reminders and all of those things, any updates needed to be given to each and every agents, this huddle or meeting. All right, 43 is station. So as you can see from that picture, you can see in the background of this picture, that's like a station. There is like a specific area in the production floor wherein your team would be taking in calls. So for example, here, this is for team A. This place, this part's gonna be team B, team C. So, you know, it would be a distribution of seats for all agents by team. And then 44 is production floor. So this is what I meant by production floor. That the one that you saw, like that picture, that's what we call production floor. There's like a huge rooms, air conditioned, fully air conditioned, full of computers of course, and a very clean room, that's what I can say, and a very cold room as well. 45 is TL. TL is an acronym for a team leader. So most of the time, he is the head of the team. So for example, we are 15 agents in one team. So he is the leader. He is the supervisor. He is like the ones who takes our supervisory call if we have one. Yeah, 46 is SME. So SME stands for subject matter expert. So they are the ones who are knowledgeable in terms of the tools that we are using, in terms of the products and the services that we have. Like, they are the living dictionary. Like, you can ask them whatever question that you have in mind in terms of the processes, and since they are expert in that matter, then they can definitely answer your question, right? And they serve as like a guide for agents, especially those newbies. But when in our company, we don't have SME. Like, in our team, we don't have SME. Our TL is the one who serves as an SME as well. Like, you can ask questions to your TL. Number 47 would be QA, or what we call quality analysts. So, quality analyst is the person who audits or listens to each and every calls an agent takes in every single day. So they are the ones who will put like give you rating based on how you handle the call, like whether you followed a certain metrics or you didn't. All right. So they're also the ones who will give you punishment sort of whenever you violated a certain rule. For example, you mislead a customer and that is a violation, then you can be escalated for doing that and your QA is the one who issue you that. And of course there will be hearings and anything like that, you know. I can talk about that if you want more. And then 50 is gonna be OM or operations manager. So he is the one who handles all of the agents. For example, we are in retail department. So in retail department, there are, for example, 5 teams. Like when you say 5 teams, there are 5 team leaders and 15 agents in each teams, for example. And all of those are under an operations manager. So that's it, guys. Right. So yeah, next is AD or associate director. So this is like a person who handles like the entire what do you call this, the program. For example, we have billing, we have technical, we have sales. So all of those are handled by AD. And then 52, money order. So this is a way for the customers to pay their bills. For example, they are like partner centers. One example I can give you about this is like Western Union, something like that. Number 53 is checking account. So this is like a payment method used by the customer. Typically, if the payment they will be doing is directly through their savings account. So they have a savings account through their bank and then they use their savings in paying your bills. So if this is in your telco account, then yeah, that's what we're gonna do. You have to ask for a routing number, the account number, and then the code at the back, and then the expiration date if there is. Right, but there's none. There's no expiration date in checking account, pardon. And then 55 would be, or 54 would be tools. So tools essentially are the software that you will be using in taking in calls. So that includes your computers, your headsets, and whatever software it is it that's inside your computer, right? So that's tools. Number 55 is voluntary time off. So voluntary time off, or what we call VTO, this is typically offered when there is overstaffing. For example, there are only few customers calling in, yet there are a lot of agents who are present at that time. So they would offer voluntary time off. And usually if you feel lazy at that day and then they offered VTO, then we say okay, yes, DL, VTO call. But I don't usually do this unless it is being like I have credit, also credit per day, and if it covers my credit, then it's okay for me to go on VTO because it's still paid. But if my credit is not enough, then I wouldn't go on VTO because I wouldn't take in calls, but I am not paid as well. So yes, be intelligent in terms of this one. And then 56 gonna be VL, or what we call vacation leave. So this is the term typically called whenever you request to your TL, like, TL, can I go on leave? I have, you know, important matter to take care of, and I did request that a 3-day vacation leave before when my cousin got married, and when I also took 2-day leave when I took like the pre-board examination for civil engineering. But yeah, I was given just 1 day at that time, but that's okay, I was able to pass luckily. And then 57 would be OB, or over break. So this is the term when you were able to exceed the allotted time. For example, our break is just 15 minutes, and you exceeded, meaning that's 16 minutes, 17 minutes. That's over break, and your TL won't be happy if you do that. 58 is SL, what we call sick leave. So yes, this is when you're sick and you wanted to file a leave. That's sick leave. I won't elaborate it. Number 59 is BPO, or business process outsourcing. So this is like just like this industry we're working, outsourcing, like basically company A from the US, for example, would hire another company, which is the company B here in the Philippines, and they would let company B do their tasks, like do the tasks of company A. And this is mainly to reduce the labor, like the cost of labor. Because if you would know, like paying an American agent would cost like four times, three to four times as much as the pay for an agent here in the Philippines. So if I am a businessman, then of course I'll choose hiring people from the Philippines because I will pay less. That means I'll earn more. Char. Like 60 would be account. So an account is basically the name of the company you'll be handling with, for example, AT&T. So that's the name of your account, which is a telco account, and that's it. Yep, I hope you've learned something from this video. If yes, please like this video. You may also visit my page. Please like my page as well. You can send me a direct message there. If you want me to refer you to the same company I'm working with, I can also do that. Send me a direct message also. Hopefully share this video, like this video if you liked it. If you don't, then that's fine. Dislike is okay. Sure. Like, follow me on my social media account. I have TikTok, I have Instagram, I also have YouTube and a Facebook page. You may also comment down below because I reply to it, to the